Hazardous radiation levels detected. Vital signs are dropping. Automatic medical systems engaged.
Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to tell you about such a radioactive metal as thorium, which has recently been found in most unexpected places. Along with uranium and bismuth, thorium is one of the three radioactive metals, which is quite abundant in the Earth's crust. Because of having an incredibly long half-life of more than 14 billion years, we figured that almost all the thorium present on the Earth had been synthesized as a result of massive explosion of a supernova or a collision of a neutron stars long before our solar system appeared. Besides, because of thorium's long half-life, it is three times as abundant as uranium in the Earth's crust. However, this element was discovered 14 years after the discovery of uranium, because its concentration in its ores is very low. Because thorium has similar chemical properties to lanthanides, in nature it is frequently found in ores containing rare earth elements. For instance, it is found in such minerals as monazite and gadolinite. Scientists have extracted at least 5 new elements from the latter mineral, including thorium. There is a thorium-rich rock in an old mine near the village of Iterby in Sweden. It contains thorium, which is why background radiation around the rock is higher than normal, even being 300 times the normal level in some places. Nevertheless, it is fairly safe, unless you live within 10 centimeters from the rock. Unfortunately, thorium wasn't discovered here. It was discovered in another part of Sweden, in a copper mine in Falun. Basically, because of the last ice age, ice removed most of the soil from the Scandinavian peninsula. Rare earth metals are much easier to find in this region than in others. After a previously unknown black mineral, which became known as gadolinite, has been found, Jakob Berzelius began studying it, and he found unknown white impregnated traces in it. He named it thorium, after a Scandinavian god Thor, because Berzelius was Swedish. However, he took his time to study the element well, and in 1929 he published his discovery. Also, after the same year, he extracted pure thorium. Speaking of pure metallic thorium, it is a gray metal, which easily oxidizes in air. It can easily be confused with cerium, which similarly covers in a dark cerium dioxide layer. Purely from a chemical point of view, thorium is more like zirconium and hafnium because of having a wide atomic radius and having F electrons on the outer shell. Thorium's compounds are usually either white or slightly yellow. Of course, for safety reasons, I am not going to grind a piece of thorium against a grinding wheel and try to dissolve it in an acid. However, if to run imaginary chemical reactions revealing thorium's chemical properties, they may differ from those of rare earth metals. Thorium can be dissolved in concentrated hydrochloric and nitric acids, just like uranium can be dissolved in nitric acid. If it was possible to grind a piece of thorium against a grinding wheel, its small particles would self-ignite in air, glowing white and forming thorium dioxide. By the way, thorium oxide is the most refractory oxide, but that's not all. At extreme temperatures, the substance can produce what's known as candoluminescence, that is an effective conversion of thermal energy into light. That was the first use of thorium in the history of humankind. If to soak a thin-knitted cotton mantle in a thorium nitrate and heat it up with a burner, thorium nitrate will break down and the mantle will glow bright blue. To give it a more natural whitish hue, you can soak the mantle in a cerium nitrate. Such gas lamps were widely used in 19th century to light up the streets, when electricity was used only to show science tricks. In such street lamps, wood gas was used as a fuel. Its flames are almost colorless, But if to soak a mantle in thorium or cerium dioxide, it will produce brighter light than that of gas or candles. By the way, such old street lamps can still be found in the streets of London, but you can no longer find thorium in them. Because of thorium high radioactivity, small thorium oxide particles, which are formed as a result of using such a lamp, can easily get into people's lungs, bombarding the thin walls of alveoli with alpha particles, thus harming your health. In the beginning of 19th, production of thorium mantle stopped, and this radioactive metal was substituted with yttrium. Because of that, brightness of such lamps decreased. However, such mantles have become significantly safer. By the way, speaking of the radioactivity, thorium, or thorium 232 to be precise, decays following the pattern you can see on the screen. In general, this element is an alpha emitter, which means that when thorium decays, it creates alpha particles, or a nucleus of a helium atom. Nevertheless, thorium decay can be observed with the naked eye, in so-called cloud chamber, or as it is also known, Wilson cloud chamber. I am using thoriated tungsten electrodes for TIG welding. I borrowed from welders I know, as a source of radiation. Thorium concentration in them is from 1 to 5%, which makes it easier to produce an arc due to the low electron work function with the addition of thorium in these electrodes. Such electrodes can be distinguished by such red marks on them and also with the help of radiation dosimeter. Background radiation produced by a bunch of such electrodes will be higher than normal, however it drops as you get further away. To make a cloud chamber, I took an aquarium and put a few dish sponges on the bottom of it, which I had soaked in pure ethanol. After that, I turned the aquarium upside down and put it on a sheet pan, placing dry ice beneath it. As the ethanol vapors descend towards the cold sheet pan, their temperature drops below the dew point and they condense. However, at first this process almost didn't happen, so I added a few more napkins soaked in ethanol. It takes around half an hour to fully stabilize the system within the cloud chamber. Roughly 3 cm above the cold bottom, there forms a layer of supersaturated alcohol vapor. When a cosmic ray or another charged particle passes through such vapor, it creates a so-called track made of condensed ethanol. If to put a few thoriated electrodes inside such a chamber, in some time you'll start noticing tracks of alpha particles flying off the electrodes. These electrodes are very easy to use because they don't have any coating which can hold back alpha particles with very low penetrating power. In air, a range of such particles is just a few centimeters, which can be seen from the length of the tracks. Of course, my cloud chamber isn't perfect, and the ethanol vapors were excessively oversaturated. Still, it is very unusual to see radiation with naked eye. Because the use of such electrodes is linked to the high radioactivity and emission of toxic thorium dioxide particles, manufacturers have recently begun adding a mixture of rare earth metals, such as lanthanum, cerium or yttrium to tungsten instead of thorium, which makes such electrode much safer. About 20 years ago, besides electrodes and mantles, thorium was also used in expensive camera lenses with thoriated glass. As you can understand, nowadays thorium doesn't have that many applications, which is why it is becoming more useless. Nowadays it is a major problem, because thorium dioxide is a useless byproduct of rare earth metals production and their extraction from such minerals as monazite and bismuth. The problem is especially severe in China, where more than 80% of the global rare earth metal production is concentrated. Because China has become a global electronics hub where their metals are used. I don't know if it's just a coincidence, but today you can buy quite unusual radioactive products on well-known internet shopping sites. I'm thankful to my subscriber who has given me such a product for my new edition. It looks like a pen for writing, but for some reason it doesn't have an ink cartridge inside and it is not clear how to write with it. Description to this pen on the website where it was purchased says that it can be used for hand massage. You can massage sensitive spots on the palms of your hands or to do pen spinning with it. Earlier, one of the YouTubers, Oleg Aizon, did a review of the pen and he found out that besides supposedly having healing properties, this pen is also radioactive. When placed next to a radiation dosimeter, it shows that background radiation is 10 times the normal level, but when it is placed 5 to 7 centimeters away from it, radiation almost doesn't exceed the normal level. Oleg Aizon even managed to take apart such a pen and saw some yellowish powder inside it, which most probably is thorium oxide. Never try this at home, because you can easily contaminate the whole building with radioactive dust, which will harm you if it gets into your lungs. As if that was not enough, you can also find a lot of other strange products on AliExpress, which as retailers claim are enriched with some magical scalar energy and irradiated with some magical rays. For instance, such a medallion, which my subscriber also kindly gave to me. It looks like a glass disc in metal frame. The green color of the glass makes it look like uranium glass. Most probably, cunning Chinese manufacturers add thorium oxide to this glass because they have nowhere else to use it. If to view alpha rays as a strange scalar energy, then there is more than enough of it in this medallion. The Chinese manufacturers should have come with a better name for it, Fru. It is noteworthy that such glass glows faint green in the ultraviolet light, which is quite unusual. Of course, I by no means recommend you to mail order such radioactive products in order for you not to be forced to prove that you are not a terrorist. Thorium, however, might have potential future uses. For instance, it might be used at nuclear power plant along with uranium. The problem is that the naturally occurring thorium-232 doesn't decay spontaneously, but can catch neutrons well and turn into thorium-233, which doesn't exist long and is acceptable to beta decay. After its decay, there forms proactinium, which radiates electron and antineutrino. After that, there forms uranium-233. This isotope of uranium can be used at nuclear power plant because it is already susceptible to spontaneous fission. However, currently there are no any thorium fuel cycle reactors, because at this point it is still not more cost-efficient than uranium fuel. Besides, production of uranium is quite complicated and upon chemical refining produces a lot of radioactive waste. Please follow the link in the description to read more about it. So, how could such an element as thorium end up being useless rare earth production waste and not be used in the industry? The Chinese manufacturers are going to great lengths to find some applications for it, because the process of disposal of radioactive thorium oxide is quite costly. We'll see what happens in the future, but as for now, thorium is a metal that no one needs. And also, for the provided thorium sample for the experiments, I'll thank the company NovaElements.com. I'll put a link to their site in the video description. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also support channel on Patreon. I'm also thankful to all of my patrons who have supported the production of science videos on this channel.